Alright, everybody, so, YouTube subscriber, on YouTube, obviously, I guess Thomas Faunt, he had a comment about having somebody build him an etcher, or an etching machine, so, I told him he could save some money if he built one himself, and I'm gonna show how I built mine. It's extremely simple and it's extremely cheap. I think mine ended up costing me like maybe $10 in parts total. Anyways, for the hand unit thing, it's nothing more than a piece of 3/8 inch thick by 3/4 inch brass bar stock that I usually use for my guards. And this one is drilled and tapped on the end here, and I stuck in a bolt and a nut on there to anchor it in place, and then file the groove around it for rubber band. And I take a piece of ordinary felt cloth, just thin felt, and stick it over the, forgive me, I'm looking through the viewfinder of my stupid camera, so I can't really do this with one hand. Anyways, I wrap the piece of felt over the end of it, cut it to fit, and then attach a rubber band to hold it in place. And for etching solution, I just use water with some vinegar and a bunch of salt added to it. Shake it up really good till the salt dissolves. Hot water works best for dissolving the salt. And then I take a piece of some speaker wire and attach, just wrap the excuse me, script wire around the bolt here and put it in some tape on it. I couldn't find any electrical tape, so I just used scotch tape. And the other end I just leave bare and put a piece of tape on it and tape it to the knife blade on the back side, and put my stencil on the front side with some tape. And here's my etcher box. So this is probably the most surprising part of the whole video. It's a power supply for, or I guess what they would call a Bachmann train track power supply. You can find them at hobby stores or Goodwills and things like that. You can generally get them for a couple of bucks. It's got a DC side and an AC side. And let's see if I can get it to light just right. 0 to 17 volt DC output and 20 volt AC output. This is the DC output side, and I just hooked the wires to it. Put the positive wire to the blade and the negative wire to the etching block. This is your AC side, and it plugs in with a simple 110 plug-in. Set this thing to about, oh, I guess I got it set on the 40 mark. If you set it one direction, it'll put DC current through, like this would be your positive side, and if you switch the switch back the other direction, this would be your negative side. So you just gotta kinda test it out and get it the right way, but it puts out enough current at the 40% mark to etch deep. The last knife I etched this morning was this one here. It's Tanto that I'm trying to finish, and if you can see that, it's a pretty deep etch, and it probably only took about, I don't know, maybe 3 minutes or something. It's not exactly the fastest etcher in the world, but it does do really good clean etches. Anyways, it'll get you a deep etch, and if you use the right etching stencils, to get some good etching stencils, you won't have any problems. And like I said, you can build this thing for under $10. It's nothing but the box, some speaker wire, a piece of brass, which you can use aluminum or copper or anything like that. Stick a bolt in it, as long as it carries a current through it. Just some felt, nice and cheap. This is just a piece of scrap that we had laying around in a box. It's paint, but I don't think it matters. And the etching solution, dip it in. Dip your hand piece here in your etching solution, and then get it slightly damp. You don't want it sopping wet or anything, but it get damp, and then you just press it onto your stencil and back and forth. Let me see if I can find a stencil here real quick. Alright. There's the stencil I was using this morning. And you just press it on here and you'll see it bubbling and popping and stuff like that. You can press it and hold it and give it, you know, count a 15 or 20 or something like that, and then release it to let it degas and for a couple of seconds, and then put it back in and start over again. Make sure you tape it down securely and tape off everything you don't want etched, because make sure you can use the scotch tape. You can actually see where you're putting your pattern. Black tape works too, but you don't see anything underneath it. Anyways, just an idea of what I do so everybody could save a little bit of money. Alright, everybody have a nice day. Thanks for watching.